Last year, I discovered that some gaming laptops were being sold with slower X16 memory. This resulted in lower FPS for games compared to faster X8 memory, which had been more popular until 2021, our great year of supply shortages. Linus even made a video covering the topic and gave credit to my initial game benchmarks showing the differences. Long story short, it was possible to boost performance quite a bit in some games with DDR4 laptops by upgrading from X16 sticks to X8 sticks. And I demonstrated this in a number of laptops, including the Legion 5 Pro and ASUS SCAR15 Advantage Edition. But is this still the case for newer gaming laptops with newer DDR5 memory? The results actually weren't what I was expecting. Just before that, I need to tell you how to get up to $1,000 Australian off Intel 11th Gen Gigabyte laptops. Gigabyte has sponsored this part of the video, so I can tell you about some serious sales they've got right now. If you're a gamer, then you're going to want to check out their Aorus lineup. With Intel's 11th Gen Core i7 processors and Nvidia's RTX 30 series graphics, you'll be covered for all your gaming needs. Otherwise, the Aero series is perfect for content creators. So what are you waiting for? Check out the deals with the sponsored link in the video description. And now back to the RAM comparison. Just like last year, gaming laptops are still only advertised with basic memory information. Take this Legion 5i Pro for example. All we know when looking at the product page is that we're getting 16 gigs of DDR5 4800 memory. You've got no idea about ranks, banks, timings, or anything else. To be fair, this information is probably a bit too technical for most people anyway, but it would still be great to have that information available somewhere for those that want it. Now, to Lenovo's credit, they do actually maintain a detailed parts list. You can look up all the parts used by a specific model and even find images that contain specific memory part numbers to search for further details. Right now though, they don't have pictures of the memory that came in my 5i Pro. It is a very new model, so maybe it just needs to be updated. Regardless, this is something that most other companies don't have. But it still has its limits. Although we can see the different types of RAM that might be used, we don't actually have any idea of what memory we'll get in the specific laptop that we buy. As we just saw for the 5i Pro in particular, there were a number of different parts listed for the memory. Am I going to get the same memory in this laptop if I buy it here in Australia? What about in the US or in the UK? What about from different stores? Or what if I buy in 6 months' time? Last year, people in different regions reported getting X8 or X16 memory in the same laptop. It seemed to vary depending on what country they bought from. At the end of the day, it just seemed like it was luck of the draw. And this was clearly problematic, because if I get sent a gaming laptop that has faster X8 memory, and most people buy it with X16, then the benchmarks that I'm showing aren't going to be applicable to most of you. Now, I also want to be clear, although I'm using Lenovo as a specific example, this isn't something that's unique to them. Last year, I found the slower X16 memory in a number of gaming laptops from a number of different brands, including ASUS, Acer, HP, and even some of Alienware's high-end expensive models. Ultimately, these companies can only buy the memory that's actually available in the market. It's not as if they make it themselves. They've all been subject to part shortages far more than you or me. The only reason I'm using Lenovo's Legion 5i Pro to do this testing is because it's the first new gaming laptop I've received with DDR5 X16 memory. And it was the Legion 5 Pro last year where I first experienced DDR4 X16 memory and found that it was slower than X8. So I figured that this was a great opportunity to follow up and find out if DDR5 memory makes as big of a difference. This is the stock memory that came in my Legion 5i Pro by default. 16 gigs of CL40 DDR5 4800 single rank X16 memory. And now this is the memory that I changed to in order to see if there's a performance difference. It's also CL40 DDR5 4800 single rank memory, but it's X8. The X8 memory is also a 32 gig kit compared to the 16 gig kit that came in my 5i Pro. So the upgrade is also double the capacity. Now before you start screaming that this isn't a fair comparison, this just seems to be how DDR5 memory is right now. I've been told that all 8GB DDR5 SODIMM laptop sticks are X16, while only the 16GB sticks and above are X8. So that would mean that this is the only way we can do this comparison. Now I can't say just how completely true this information is, but if we take a look at the DDR5 laptop SODIMM sticks currently available from either Crucial or SK Hynix, it does indeed appear to be the case, at least right now in early 2022. While this might still not sound fair due to the capacity difference, I've shown in this video here that it doesn't seem to really affect gaming as long as you've got more than 16 gigs in dual channel. So I don't think the differences between 16 gigs and 32 gigs of DDR5 memory are going to play play that big, if any, role in our game comparisons. We should be seeing the results between X8 and X16, if any. Anyway, that's more than enough explanation. We've tested 10 games at two different resolutions to show you all of the differences. Let's start out with Forza Horizon 5. We've got results with the native 2560 by 1600 screen resolution above, and we've also tested 1080p below. Both were done because memory differences usually matter more at lower resolutions. And I wanted this data to be applicable to other laptops as well, not just the 5i Pro with its above 1440p screen. Anyway, at 1080p, we're seeing just a 4% boost with X8 memory, with basically no change at the higher resolution. A little extra in the 1% low with X8, but that's it. I was really keen to see the Shadow of the Tomb Raider results, because this game shows some of the biggest differences when it comes to memory. Although last year there was a 12% performance boost at 1080p by swapping from X16 to X8 memory on the Strix G15, we're seeing basically no difference here with DDR5. Far Cry 6 was kind of weird. The average FPS was basically the same regardless of memory. However, the 1% lows at 1080p were far lower compared to the X16 stock memory that just came in the 5i Pro. Not sure what the deal was here, but this is the only time anything like this happened in a consistently reproducible way, so it seems like a bit of an outlier. Rainbow Six Siege had the biggest difference out of all 10 games tested, with a massive 4% higher average FPS at 1080p. Alright, I'm being a bit sarcastic there, but there just aren't huge differences with DDR5. CSGO also had above average gains with the X8 memory at 1080p, but it's margin of error stuff, and when you're above 500 FPS, I'd argue this doesn't really matter. Red Dead Redemption 2 had a massive 1 FPS difference in either direction depending on the resolution, so nothing serious here. God of War was similar at 1080p, while the higher resolution was a couple of FPS ahead with the stock memory, a small trend that we'll see through most of the games tested. Microsoft Flight Simulator was about the same at either resolution, like a 1 FPS difference best case, big deal. Cyberpunk 2077 had a 3 FPS gain at 1080p with X8 memory, a 3% gain, and this was the third best improvement with X8 memory. It really doesn't seem like it matters here. Watch Dogs Legion saw the biggest difference in a bunch of games in the big RAM comparison I did a few months ago, linked below the video, so I figured it would be a good one to test all the setting presets with. Generally, we'd expect the memory difference to have a bigger effect at lower setting levels. And yeah, sure, while the X8 memory in the red bars was further ahead at low settings compared to Ultra, we're talking about a 3% gain. Nothing major. Interestingly, the higher resolution actually had higher gaps at the higher setting presets. But again, best case, we're still talking about a 3 to 4 FPS difference. Not exactly a change that's worth buying new memory for, and smaller compared to DDR4. All testing up until now has been done with Optimus disabled for best performance, as the 5i Pro offers this feature. So to see if the integrated graphics behave differently, we've also tested one game with Optimus on. To be fair, we are seeing a slightly larger difference compared to with Optimus off, which at 1080p only saw the X8 memory one frame higher than X16. But still, this is only a relatively small 3% boost. Not quite the 10% boost in the same game with last year's DDR4 Legion 5 Pro. These are the average differences out of all 10 games tested at the lower 1080p resolution. On average, we're looking at less than a 2% FPS boost with the X8 memory. Basically, nothing at all. Best case, we're barely seeing a 4% gain in Rainbow Six Siege. And given that one was above 300 FPS, does it really matter? The difference is so small that it even confirms the size difference of 16 gigs versus 32 gigs doesn't matter. We're just not seeing enough of any sort of difference here to make a RAM upgrade worth it. Things change a bit at the higher native 2560 by 1600 resolution. The memory difference should matter less at the higher resolution as we're more GPU bound. And that seems to be the case, as on average there's a smaller gap. There was actually a slight trend towards the X8 memory doing better here, but it's a very small difference either way at less than 3% towards either option. Despite the differences in games not being much at all, the latency reported by the Ada 64 cache and memory benchmark was a fair bit different. The X8 memory was around 10% faster in this regard. Read and write speeds were also higher with the X8 memory. I'm not sure how much of a difference, if any, the 16GB and 32GB capacities would make here.
I was recently chatting to someone that works at one of the big laptop companies and asked if they were also seeing basically no difference between X8 and X16 DDR5 memory. And they said that as far as they were aware, it just wasn't going to be a concern with DDR5 memory this generation. Which makes sense when you consider the technical aspects, because DDR5 doubles the the number of bank groups while leaving the number of banks per bank group the same, which increases efficiency compared to DDR4. You won't get memory sticks with only two bank groups with DDR5, as per this Micron white paper. This enables controllers to avoid performance degradation associated with sequential memory access within the same bank. I might see if there are any differences with Ryzen 6000 in future once I get it in for testing, but based on what I just said, there's probably no point. DDR5 just seems better than DDR4 in this regard. I'd rather not just blindly state that without testing it though, and only rely on the results from one laptop, so make sure you're subscribed for future memory testing content. Check out this video next to find the optimal memory configuration that you should be using in your gaming laptop. We've tested a crazy amount of memory configurations to find out which ones give you the best performance in games. So I'll see you in that one next.